A long time ago, a very, very, very long time ago, when I was in grammar school, I used to serve a lot of weddings. I wish I could say it was all about piety, but you usually got a tip for serving a wedding. So I look forward to those chances. But in those faraway days, couple were getting married, the priest did not give an individual homily, or even sermon, as they called it in those days. Instead, he read out the matrimonial exhortation. It was the tradition of Christian marriage being passed on to those couples beginning their married life. We stopped using it just about the time I think our culture was allowing marriage to melt down. And I have always found the words to be challenging and beautiful. Although you're celebrating anniversaries, I think it might not be a bad idea to listen and savor those words of exhortation describing the Christian mystery of sacramental marriage. Dear friends in Christ, as you know, you are about to enter into a union that is most sacred and most serious, a union established by God Himself. By it, He gave humankind a share in the greatest work of creation, the work of the continuation of the human race. And in this way, He sanctified human love, enabled man and woman to help each other live as children of God by sharing a common life under His fatherly care. Because God Himself is thus its author, marriage is, of its very nature, a holy institution, required of those who enter into it a complete and unreserved giving of self. But Christ our Lord added to the holiness of marriage an even deeper meaning and an even higher beauty. He referred to the love of marriage to describe His own love for His bride, the church. That is, for the people of God who He redeemed by shedding His own precious blood. And so He gave to Christians a new vision of what married life ought to be. A life of self-sacrificing love like His own. It is for this reason that His apostle St. Paul clearly states that marriage is now and for all time to be considered a great mystery, intimately bound up with the supernatural union of Christ and the Church, which union is also to be its pattern. This union then is most serious because it will bind you together for life in a relationship so close and so intimate that it will profoundly influence your whole future. That future with its hopes and disappointments, its successes and its failures, its pleasures and its pains, its joys and its sorrows, is hidden from your eyes. You know that these elements are mingled in every life and are to be expected in your own. And so, not knowing what is before you, you take each other for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death. Truly, then, these words are most serious. It is a beautiful tribute to your undoubted faith in each other that, recognizing their full import, you are nevertheless so willing and ready pronounce these vows. Because these words involve such solemn obligations, it is most fitting that you principle of self-sacrifice. As you begin your married life by the voluntary and complete surrender of your individual lives in the interest of that deeper and wider life which you are now to have in common. Henceforth, you belong entirely to each other. You will be one in mind, one in heart, and one in affections. And whatever sacrifices you may hereafter be required to make to preserve this common life, always make them generously. Sacrifice is usually difficult and irksome. Only love makes it easy, and perfect love can make it a joy. We are willing to give in proportion as we are willing to love. And when love is perfect, the sacrifice is complete. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. And the Son so loved us that he gave himself up for our salvation. Greater love than this no man hath than that they lay down their life for their friends. No greater blessing can come to your married life than pure conjugal love, loyal and true to the end. May then this love with which you join your hands and hearts today never fail, but grow deeper and stronger as the years go on. And if true love, an unselfish spirit of perfect sacrifice, guide your every decision, you can expect the greatest measure of earthly happiness that may be allotted to man in this valley of tears. The rest is in the hands of God, nor will God be wanting to your needs. He will pledge you the lifelong support of his graces in the Holy Sacrament, which you are now about to receive.